So for this problem, imagine that one summer you're feeling particularly adventurous, and you dig a hole straight through the center of the Earth, and by some miracle you don't end up roasting yourself in the Earth's core or anything like that, you manage to dig all the way through to the other side of the Earth. And to celebrate the completion of your big summer project, you decide to leap dramatically into your tunnel to head towards the other side of the Earth. Now it turns out, if you were to do this, you would actually oscillate back and forth between the Earth's surface on this side and the Earth's surface on this side. And lo and behold, it turns out that this motion through the Earth's core is actually simple harmonic motion. To see why this is simple harmonic motion, we're going to have to investigate what gravity is like within the Earth. We know what it's like above the Earth, but what is it like inside of the Earth? It turns out that the force of gravity within the Earth's surface is equal to little g times your mass divided by the radius of the Earth, and then times your current radius, so your distance away from the center of the Earth, which I'm calling r here. Now, it's possible to derive this equation from scratch, but the derivation is quite complicated, so I'm not going to do it here, but you should discuss that on the forums. So the key thing we see about this equation is that the force grows proportionally with the distance away from the center of the Earth. And where have we seen this before? Well, it looks exactly like Hooke's law, which says that the force a spring pulls on an object is equal to the spring constant times its displacement away from the center. So this equation for the force of a spring looks just like this equation for the force of gravity within the Earth's surface, except instead of x, we use r, and instead of k, we have gm over the radius of the Earth. Okay, now that you know how gravity scales within the Earth, I want you to tell me, what's the period of this simple harmonic motion? So how long does it take for you to return to your original starting point once you jump in the Earth, completing one complete cycle here? And put your answer in minutes. And for this problem, you should use 10 meters per second squared for little g, and you should use 6,400 kilometers for the radius of the Earth. Good luck.